I'm here to bring you a channeled message. Let's see who this is for. First of all, I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but we do have mandatory soul school homework from Miss Star. Yes, we have to listen to the U of M keynote address given by Dessa back in 2012. All right. Mandatory homework. Okay. No exceptions. All right. We must learn how to fail. Oh, okay. All right. Ms. Star wants you to know that. Okay. All right. Who is this reading for? Who needs to learn how to fail? Who's worried about failing right now? Who is this for? Who is this for? Whoa. Oh, my gosh. Okay. Let's see. Okay. Gemini is here. Okay. All of those landed face up. And Taurus is just hanging. All right. You guys ready to learn how to fail? Okay. If you haven't heard of Dessa, she is quite an inspiration. She is a rapper, a singer, an essayist, a teacher, an entrepreneur, all sorts of things. She's pretty amazing, has a brilliant mind. All right. She has an amazing speech reminding us all how to fail. All right. And you know what, you guys? I can attest to it. Because I used to be afraid of failure all the time. And it's that ego. It just gets in the way. And it totally prevents you. It's like literally making you get in your own way of your own success. So it's important we listen to Miss Star's homework. I'll put the link for our homework down in the comments. Right. Okay. We have judgment happening. Okay. Let's see. Judgment, we're learning a lesson. Okay, somebody's really worried about failing. Okay. They may have to make a judgment on something. All right. We're definitely going to clarify. Let's see. Okay, tell us more. What is this? I can tell you guys, the more you fail at things, the easier it is to fail. Yes. The less it hurts, that nasty ego, because you get used to it. You hear about the authors that have to send their book to a billion publishers? Guess what? Somebody I know just got picked up by a publisher. Uh-huh. It happened. If she had been afraid of failing, never would have happened for her. Okay? If you're afraid of what is out there for you and you're not willing to take the chance, if you're not willing to trust spirit, trust your own intuition, trust the universe, the lessons you know about yourself, only you know what's best for you. When you get to that point, then failing doesn't matter. You know what sucks more than failing? Regret. Yep. Mm-hmm. See this chick? She's looking down. She's saying, can I make that jump? Can my dog make the jump? I might F up my dress. I don't care. I'm gonna try. All right, we have Temperance and the Empress coming in here. All right. It's only when you truly understand that failure isn't something to be afraid of is when you really can get into this Supreme Empress energy. Let's talk about Prince playing at the Super Bowl when it rained. The big show freaking washed out. Guess what he did? He used it as a freaking prop and did the best halftime Super Bowl show ever. I'll put it down in the comments. Make sure you watch it. Because you know what? He wasn't afraid to fail. His dancers dancing on their giant heels in the freaking rain. You're gonna die when you see this performance because it's amazing. They weren't afraid to fail. They freaking went for it. And you know what? They're part of the most amazing halftime show ever with the most amazing prop ever, the rain. Oh, yeah. Okay. Okay, let's see what else next. Okay. Now I hear Dessa again singing Jump Rope. Okay. We have the Three of Swords, the Star, and the Three of Pentacles. Somebody may have healed from a wound, a failure. This was a big one. And the Star came in, helped heal this wound, this healing energy, this Aquarian energy. All right. And now you're jump roping. This is the jump rope, okay? You have to listen to that Dessa song. It was just jump rope then. Try not to get hit. Don't let it talk it down. It's still jump rope now. Okay, yep, double dutching. Okay. All right, okay. All right, let's clarify. Okay. Bottom of the deck, Eight of Swords. This is afraid to fail, right here. We gotta get this rope off your wrist. Mm-hmm. So you can grab that one sword and go. All you need is that one sword, the Ace of Clarity, the truth, the vision. Because then you get your Ace of Pentacles. Yeah. All right. You have to fail, guys. You have to try over and over again. You can't let ego hold you back. It's straight up a numbers game, for sure. And once you think about that, it's not an ego game, it's a numbers game. You know, I've reached out to people, I've said, hey, you want to collaborate? People have totally freaking, I reached out to Dessa, she collaborated with me. We made a merch necklace, we made a bunch of money off it. It was a totally fun project. You know, when I reached out to her after I watched that freaking video of her speech on how to fail, yeah. You got to take the chances. That's all there is to it. It's, it says nothing about you if you don't get it. Other people I've reached out to, I haven't even bothered to answer an email back. You gotta try. You gotta find people that inspire you. And if, you know, it doesn't work out, it doesn't work out. Move on to the next one. That's okay. That was just a connection. It wasn't a builder. That's a lesson from, what's his name? Matthew Hussey? Yeah. All this is going in the comments, my loves. Make sure you hit subscribe. My readings are interactive. Hit subscribe to my channel before you click link so you can find your way back. Yeah. All right. Okay, let's clarify, you guys. Oh my gosh, let's clarify. Holy cow. Okay, I see. What do the butterflies want to tell everybody about this lesson on failure? All right, you need to learn this, okay? You might be at a point where you're changing. May have lots of new opportunities presented to you. Spirit's trying to prepare you, okay? Don't let the ego get in the way, okay? I am fulfilling my purpose for all the people who need me. All right, fantastic. Okay. Okay. What does judgment want to tell everybody here? Oops, one deck. Let's do this. Actually, I think I'm supposed to clarify with this deck. What does judgment want to tell everybody here, please? Judgment for everybody. Whoa, that did a spin. I don't know if I caught it. Okay, let's see what we got. Okay. Somebody wants to come forward to a really successful person, okay? This person does give all sorts of advice, opportunities, okay? They think there could be like all sorts of good opportunities within these people, okay? And they think they can jump in the jump rope too, okay? They've been watching for a long time and they've just been afraid to fail for quite a long time, but they want to do it, okay? They've been just hanging in the bag, trying to make up their mind, trying to make a decision, all right? Okay, they feel like they're strong enough now, okay? They feel like they can jump rope without seeing the ropes and not get hit, okay, perfect. This person has decided and learned that they're ready to take the leap into something, okay? They may not know what the future holds with that, but life is exciting, okay? They want to play, all right? Let's hear about that. What does the moon and the fool have to say to everybody? Okay, we have the Knight of Pentacles, the Emperor, and the Seven of Swords. Okay. Okay, this person. So both of these are Aries energies. This might be the same person. Okay. They may have just been sitting back for a while, just kind of being stubborn, doing their own thing, maybe just possibly taking care of their own empire, okay? Whatever it was, though, they were watching the other person, and they were learning, but they weren't coming forward. They were wearing a mask, and they were learning about this person, okay? They may have been, like, acknowledging some sort of shadow work type stuff, but like doing it in secret. Okay. And now they may want to come forward and go on this new adventure. They might just appear out of nowhere. Okay. What is Temperance here with the Empress? Temperance and the Empress. I keep wanting to say Empress. Oh. Okay, imprints. Okay. These people may have imprinted on each other. Okay. That's what Temperance was doing, was imprinting. Okay, so these two were totally enchanted with each other. The Empress and the Emperor. Here they are, the divine couple, right here. They're both in Empress and Emperor energy. All right. Temperance imprinted them with each other. All right. Let's see what that says. What does this say for everybody? Okay, both of these people had a lot of options. They had a lot of personal healing and work they had to do, okay? And then they may have just like a lot of options in life on what they want to do right now. They both want the same thing. They want this Ace of Pentacles, okay? And there is the opportunity right now for the Ace of Pentacles. One is an Empress energy and one is an Emperor energy. All right. We have Temperance here. She had been working on this for quite a long time. These people are totally enchanted with each other. They both may want to start a new beginning together. They are each other's Nine of Cups. All right. And it's the end of this kind of cycle thing. Okay. Okay, there's Tani Katane. She wants to come and play pool. Okay. All right. I did a, somebody may ask somebody out on a date. They may ask them to play pool. Okay. Okay. She's coming to play pool with the mind games they played with them. Okay. All right. Okay. I see it now. Okay. I have this deck. I got this deck. Okay, I'll clarify it with this deck. That has pool balls on it, and it's a bad idea to play mind games with somebody. And this person, the masculine, learned that it was a bad idea to play mind games with her, with the feminine. Tani Katane is in another reading that I just did. I don't remember who it's for. All right, he's learning it. He's learning. She's awesome. Okay, it's the end of the lesson. Okay, he's realizing how magical she is. It's his Nine of Cups. Okay. Okay. Clarify that for these guys with this deck. This deck has to say something because those pool balls were in there. Okay. Okay, he might talk about opening his heart chakra. He may have been like stubborn, but he learned something and it made him open his heart chakra, and now he finds this Empress like super hot. Okay, he may have like hissed at her or something, because I see this like licking. Licking the Wolverine, okay. Like, only she can handle this person, okay. And he knows it, okay. This is on the floor, okay. His third eye has opened, okay. In the past, he realizes he may have been... Oh, the energy vampire. He may have been unwell, unhealed, all right, cloaked up to this feminine, all right, because he was a hungry, hungry hippo. And the hungry, hungry hippo is, they can be selfish at times, and they're just trying to get all the pellets themselves because they haven't really been properly loved. They haven't really been shown proper love before. And he's starting to understand that now, and he's looking at this past behavior, and it does embarrass him, all right? She may have been trying to lick him and make him feel better, and he may have been like a Wolverine at her, and he's reflecting back at that, okay? That's, the spirit is like working with him, okay? And what is this? Okay, this may have been the hungry, hungry hippo thing, the Three of Swords. There may have been some sort of betrayal, some sort of something like that. All right? But Spirit sent in the Star. The Star is super healing energy. All right? Somebody may have had a glow up. Okay, too. All right? So they could jump rope super good. Okay? Let's hear about that. Okay. Let's hear about this. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Okay. This person is seeing signs from the universe. They may have had an awakening. Yeah. They want to be a phoenix rising from the ashes. Okay. I'm only going to take face-ups. This person feels like a doofus. All right. They're seeing signs from the universe. I looked at this when I saw this. Nobody is a doofus. So we have to put that out there. I mean, I guess there are doofusy people, but this person isn't a doofus. They just hadn't known. They hadn't learned, okay? But they are seeing signs from the universe now. And look it! They have freedom from... And this was right by the hungry, hungry hippo. They have freedom from the hungry, hungry hippo. Okay. And now they want to pounce on opportunities. Yay! Right on. We have to remember not to let our egos get in our way. There's so many awesome opportunities to pounce on if you allow yourself to have these opportunities, you guys. Mm-hmm. For sure. All right, what's the final message for everybody? What's the final message for everybody? We'll see. The Eight of Pentacles. All right. This particular Eight of Pentacles is, for me, is this person doing the work? They're doing self-healing. This person is doing whatever it takes to just get in a better spot. All right. She's not afraid to try new things, okay? She's not afraid to do this painting. She's working on a painting right now, all right? She never would have painted before, but she doesn't care now. She's ready to try it, and guess what? She likes it. It's fun, all right? So Spirit may want you to try new things, all right? And don't be afraid to fail. The more you try things, the less scary it gets. All right, fantastic, perfect messages. All right, guys, if you like how I read, please hit like and subscribe. You can join the Star Gang. We're learning life lessons in a cool and neat way. Here, let's do this. Ooh, Emperor and Empress. Heck yeah. If you like how I read, please hit a thumbs up. It helps me, helps my channel, and I appreciate it. Thanks, guys. And if you want to increase my Etsy shop, there's a link right there in the description. All right, Gemini, Virgo, Cancer, and Aquarius, don't forget to do your homework. Have you ever seen Miss Star go supernova? Oh, you don't want to see it. Better do your homework. I'll put it down in the comments. All right, peace out.